The internet is flooded with demonstrations and tutorials of vibe coding, but not many people will show you what code the tools have written in your software. That is precisely what I will do today. I will show you the code, and I will explain you why that code is not the result of software development and why you cannot learn programming by reading that code. Let me start an example. I will be using Claude Sonnet 4 model, which supposedly writes some good code. It does produce code that mostly works, but okay, let's try it. Implement a working snake game that can play in the terminal. Develop the game in C sharp. And then comes one detail which people who are not software developers will probably not remember or not know to tell. Apply good practices of software design. Make a good separation of classes and types. Let's see what AI will generate upon this request. It will be working for a couple of minutes, like 2 or 3 minutes. I will use that time to give you my views on vibe coding. People use it regularly to develop software when they are not trained or educated software developers. That is one category of people doing this. People also use vibe coding to learn programming. Both practices are generally all right. Anyone should be able to become a software developer. But using vibe coding to attain that goal is dubious at least. Let me put it this way. Can you design a car without knowing anything about mechanics, about materials? I don't think so. What makes anyone think that they can develop a working software, and I don't think a time tracking software, because that already exists. I mean real industrial software, software that makes money, that makes value, without knowing software development. That is already insane. Just think about it. The second problem is when you try to learn software development using AI tools. That seems like something that might work. However, at the current state of technology, you will face a serious obstacle there. AI tools today are trained on the publicly available source code on the internet. Only a tiny fraction of publicly available software is written by real professionals who do that well. The best code is not publicly available, and AI tools did not have it during their training. So you, if you want to learn software development from AI tools, you will be learning from bad code. Now that is an issue. Let's see what the tool has made. I see the effort behind this code, but I will tell you right away that this implementation is ridden by issues when you view it as a senior software developer. Let me unveil you one secret. I have run this several times, and every time I got a substantially different solution. The problem with AI tools is that they cannot decide on their opinions, and every design is opinionated. A much bigger issue is with the structure and implementation of this code. So let's pretend that you are currently learning software development from code generated by AI, that you are a student. What can you learn from code like this? There is a position with two public properties, X and Y. There is a constructor. There is equality implemented, like two instances are equal if X and Y are equal. Okay, there is hashing, get hash code. There are the operators, equal and not equal. Come on, this is not C sharp. First, nobody uses structs anymore. It's a record struct with int x, int y, and delete everything below this line. This is C sharp. Now, of course, there is no reason to use block namespaces anymore, file scoped namespace. This is the entire file that does everything you could see on this screen. Now, that is the issue I must always point out when talking about AI tools. They have been trained on publicly available code. Publicly available code has two fundamental issues. One, its average age is huge on the scale at which software and programming languages evolve. If you have average age of code on the internet of 10 years, programming now and 10 years ago are not the same industries. What you could see generated in this file originally is a very, very old code. We don't write C-sharp code like that anymore. The second problem on the publicly available code is that it was written by people who do not understand programming concepts all too well. Let me show you what I have seen in the implementation of Snake. It has a list of positions representing the body, but then comes the issue. The head is the body at index 0, so the first element in the list is the head. How does moving work? Well, here is the issue that immediately caught my attention. Nobody writes an insert into a list at position 0, because this operation takes time proportional to the size of the list. As your snake, if you are playing this game and your snake becomes very large, this will take dozens or a hundred steps to complete. This is the wrong choice of a data structure. So we have seen two fundamental issues already in code, and it took me half a minute to discover them. One is using very old syntax, which is deprecated. The other is much greater, using wrong data structures. We should use probably a linked list here. A linked list lets you isolate the head and quickly insert items at the head and remove items from the tail. That is how the snake is moving in the game. Whoever wrote this code out there on the internet, hey, you used the wrong data structure. Let me show you another issue here. I know it's there. We programmers immediately recognize this problem as a race condition. Two parts of the code are trying to print things on the terminal at the same time. How could an AI tool generate an entire software project without understanding that there are two entities sharing the same console output? What other problems exist there? Security? How will it handle network traffic, database? If it cannot figure such a simple thing as a UI thread, you might use vibe coding as a helping tool while learning software development. But the best advice I have for you for now is to keep learning software development from books You can supplement the books with courses, videos, and then use vibe coding to check what you have learned and to capture the issues in the generated code, to try to fix them using your own knowledge. That will make a software developer out of you. But just putting your luck in the hands of AI will not get you there, I'm sorry.